In this lesson, we'll discuss with nouns. Nouns are called naming words. Various names like Rohan, Rita, Rose, Redcoat, and many more are called nouns. This particular part of speech helps us in categorizing things, animals, people, monuments, and whatever we see all around us. Nouns play a very important role in English language. Without them, it would be very difficult in distinguishing people and objects around us. Right from our childhood, when we grew up, we distinguish between everything around us we see by their names. We call them by specific names. Name of a boy, name of a girl, name of a building, name of a school, name of a hospital, name of any organization, name of a tree, name of a flower. So names play a very important role in our day-to-day life. In my next lesson, I'll be discussing with the classifications of nouns. Hope you enjoyed till now. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to my channel. I'll be waiting for your valuable suggestions and your valuable comments. Stay tuned till my next lesson. Bye-bye. We are continuing with lesson 2. Most important, we frequently use classification of nouns. Proper nouns, fixed names. Taj Mahal, Redcoat, Rohan, Ramesh. These names belong to particular historical monuments and persons. These names cannot be substituted. Common names or common nouns, means that are used to classify or generalize boy, girl, class, pen, etc. These terms are used in distinguishing objects that are living or non-living around us. Collective nouns, nouns that are used to describe a collection of objects. For example, a swarm of bees, a flight of stairs, a fleet of ships. Till now, we have discussed three kinds of frequently used nouns: proper, common, collective. If you are having any doubts, please do write in the comment box or ask me any questions you like. I would be ready to help you anytime. In the last part of lesson 2, we'll discuss about abstract nouns. These are nouns that cannot be seen or touched. These can only be felt or realized. For example, honesty, courage, bravery, cleanliness. The words that I have mentioned in the example can only be felt or realized. They cannot be seen or touched. The most frequently used categories of nouns have been discussed. I hope you have enjoyed. But still, if there are any doubts or you want to discuss with me the problems you face while dealing with these parts of grammar, please do write in the comment box. And do not forget to like or subscribe to my channel. The more you practice, the better will be your quality of speaking. I hope my lessons are really helping you. Bye-bye.